Well, they've done it again. Motion VFX has once again redefined what's possible with Final Cut Pro. Today, we're taking a look at CineStudio, a brand new offering from Motion VFX that's going to completely change the way you edit videos. This plugin pack includes some of the most powerful products from Motion VFX, including two brand new plugins that are going to blow your mind. Amroro AI, a plugin that uses artificial intelligence to rotoscope and track any object in your clip, and M-Surface Tracker, a tool that allows you to place and track graphics on any surface. First, let's take a look at Amroro AI. This plugin lets you mask and track basically any object in your video, and it's fast and simple to use. Let's use Amroro AI to rotoscope the subject in our first clip. After installation, we can find this tool in our effects browser in the Amroro AI category. Let's grab this effect and drag and drop it over our clip. Right away, we get these super handy, movable on-screen controls and a few controls in the inspector window. Before we can select our subject, we first need to select the precision of our track. Our options are accurate, fast, or super fast. When masking and tracking people, I always recommend the accurate method. Let's go to the viewer window, make sure we have the intelligent selection tool selected, and draw over our subject. This doesn't have to be perfect, just make sure all parts of your subject are selected. After you let go of the mouse button, your selection is highlighted in blue. For a simple clip like this, our selection should be perfect right off the start. But if it's not, we can manually adjust it. We'll take a look at that in a couple minutes. For now, if the selection looks good, we can move on to the next step, tracking our subject. Click on the tracker button, and depending on your playhead's position, track forwards or backwards. In our example, the playhead's in the middle of our clip, so let's first track backwards. This step might take a couple minutes, depending on the complexity of your clip. Once our clip is tracked all the way back to the start, the pop-up window closes and we're back to our original playhead position. We now need to track the clip after the playhead, so simply click the track forward button and watch this plugin do its thing. After our track is complete, we have a few options for checking and adjusting our mask. With a merged output, we see the masked part of the clip, highlighted in blue, over our original clip. If we select mask only, we can just see the mask of our clip. Masked video shows us the mask with a video inside of it, and the video output shows us our original clip. Let's select masked video and adjust our mask. In the inspector window, we can adjust the smoothness of our mask, shrink or expand it, add some blur to the edges, and even invert it. After rotoscoping our subject, the most obvious thing to do here is to replace our background. We can just grab another clip and connect it under our timeline for a simple background replacement. But there's so much more we can do here. For example, we can add a specific look to just our subject and leave the background untouched. To do this, we just select our clip and make a copy of it by holding down the Option key and dragging straight up. Select the bottom clip and, in the inspector window, deselect Amroro AI. We'll select our top clip again, go to the effects browser, and let's add a super obvious effect like the comic look just for demo purposes. We'll grab the comic ink effect and add it to our top clip. Make the necessary adjustments in the inspector window to get it looking just the way you like. With just a couple simple steps, we have this cool video effect. The great thing about Amroro AI is it's not just used for tracking people like Final Cut Pro's background removal tool. Amroro AI can also be used to track objects. Let's use it to change the color of the pillow in this next clip. We'll grab this tool again and add it to our clip. When rotoscoping simple objects, we can save some time by using one of the faster precision settings. Let's try super fast. We'll draw over the object we want to rotoscope, and if our selection looks good, let's track our clip. To change the color of our pillow, once again, we can make a copy of the clip and deselect Amroro AI in our bottom copy. Select the top clip again, and change the output method to masked video. Go to the color inspector, add a hue saturation curves correction, and select the hue versus hue curve. We'll sample the color we want to change and adjust the middle control point to get our desired color. With just a couple simple steps, we change the color of our pillow without affecting any other parts of our clip. Next, let's take a look at a more complicated example. We'll use Amroro AI to isolate the dancer in this clip and add a neon sign on the wall behind her. Once again, we'll add Amroro AI to our clip, change the precision method to accurate, and draw over our dancer to select her. This time, our selection is far from perfect, so let's delete it and try again. There's a couple things we can do to make our track more accurate. First thing we can do is try adding more contrast to our clip with a color correction. Let's go to our effects browser, make sure all video and audio is selected, search for the contrast effect, and add it to our clip. We'll add the Emerald AI effect. And let's try drawing over our subject again. This time, our selection is much better, but still not quite perfect. If we zoom in on our clip, you can see some areas are missed, and there's a few spots selected that shouldn't be. Let's fix the missing areas first. With the auto selection tool still selected, we can draw over the missed areas and complete our selection. Another option here is to use the manual brush. If you take a closer look at the selection tool, you'll see a small drop-down arrow in the corner. If we click on this arrow, we get an option for a manual brush. When we select it, a slider pops up at the bottom of the viewer window we can use to adjust the brush size. We can now pick our size and manually fill in the missing areas. Now, to fix the parts that weren't supposed to be selected, Emerald AI also comes with an intelligent and a manual eraser tools. Let's click on the eraser in the toolbar to select the intelligent eraser and brush over a clip to see if it removes the unnecessary parts. In this case, the intelligent eraser is not our best option. Let's press Command-Z to undo that. Open the eraser dropdown and select the manual eraser. We'll make our eraser a bit smaller and manually remove the selected parts that are outside of our subject. Once we're happy with our selection, we can go ahead and track our clip. Now, for the neon sign, to save some time, I've pre-made one with the MTitle 3D expansion pack and tracked it to our clip using the MTracker 3D plugin, both of which, by the way, are included with the CineStudio 3D pack. If we place it over a clip, you can see it's tracked perfectly to the camera movement, but it's overlaid on top of our subject. To place it between the subject and the wall, just like before, we need to make a copy of our clip and layer it above the original clip and the neon sign clip. Now, all we need to do is switch our top clip output to masked video, select the bottom clip, and disable Emerald AI. Also, after a clip has been tracked, we can disable a color correction we applied earlier to add contrast to both clips. Here's our finished result. Emerald AI is an amazing plugin, and even by itself, in my opinion, it's worth the price of CineStudio. But you also get another brand new, amazing plugin with this pack, MTracker Surface. MTracker Surface is a tracking plugin that is so much better than Final Cut Pro's built-in object tracker. Besides tracking the position, rotation, and scale of objects in our clips, MTracker Surface also lets us track perspective for overlaying graphics on solid and even changing surfaces. Let's take a look at a couple examples. In our first example, let's add a graphic to the wall behind our subject and track it to follow the camera movement. We'll go back to our effects browser, select the MTracker Surface category, and add this effect to our clip. Just like with Emerald AI plugin, as soon as we add this to our clip, we get some handy on-screen controls. It's worth mentioning too that these are laid out in order we use them. First up is the selection tool. We can use this just like the draw mouse tool that comes with Final Cut Pro to select the area we want to track. All we do is click in the viewer window to add control points to outline the tracking area. Clicking on the first control point completes our selection. Once our selection is completed, we get another set of gray control points connected to the points we added. These are used to add some feathering to our mask. Dragging these out away from our control points reveals a feathering ring. This serves two purposes. First, this can be used to feather out the graphic we're tracking, which in some cases will help it blend in better. Another reason we may want to use this is this feathering area actually helps us get a more accurate track. Once our selection is complete, we can go back to our toolbar and move on to step two, the tracking type. We can set this to track the position of our clip, position and rotation, position, rotation, and scale, or the one we want to use for this example, perspective tracking. Next, if we have anything move over the tracking area, we can manually add a mask to tell MTracker Surface to ignore that area. We won't need that for this example. Our next step is tracking our clip, just like before. We'll click the track button, and depending on our playhead's position, track forwards, backwards, or both. This tracks our selected area throughout the clip, even when it moves out of frame. After our track is complete, let's click on the image button to add a graphic to our tracked area. We'll head over to the video inspector, Click on the Drop Zone button and select an image we want to add to our clip. Right below the Drop Zone button, we have our Pan and Scale controls. These are used to adjust the size of our image to fit it inside our tracked area. To match our perspective of our background, we can use the controls in our viewer window to distort our drop zone image. Next up is image effects, and we can use these to better blend our image with our background. Selecting this button lets us match the white balance of our clip, set the color levels, add blur, motion blur, a drop shadow, light wrap, and even add grain to match our clip. For this example, let's add some blur to our graphic, and maybe a little bit of grain. We can use the sliders at the bottom to adjust the size and intensity. Also, over in the inspector window, let's bring down the opacity a bit and change the blend mode to multiply to show the lines between our bricks. If we play back our clip, the graphic is tracked perfectly to our clip's background. Let's try another clip, and this time use the mesh tracker to track an irregular surface and add a graphic to it. We'll first skim our clip and place our playhead on a frame where the area we want to track is the flattest. Let's add the M-Tracker surface effect to our clip and select an area we want to track. For a more accurate track, we'll drag out on the gray control points to add a feathering ring. With our tracking area selected, let's change the tracking type to mesh tracking and go ahead and track our clip. Once the track is complete, we'll head over to the inspector window, add an image to our drop zone, and adjust it to blend it in with our clip. Let's see what our finished track looks like. Pretty fucking cool, isn't it? The MROTO AI and M-Tracker Surface are only two of the over 15 plugins included with CineStudio 3D. You also get M-Tracker 3D, 9 expansion packs, M-Film Look, M-Flare 2, M-Puppet, and much more, with more exclusive expansion packs and plugins to come. All these tools and extension packs included will cost you thousands of dollars, while with CineStudio 3D, you get access for one full year for roughly the price equal to M-Tracker 3D. You can even try it risk-free for 14 days, but let me warn you, after you try it, you will want to keep it. Also, if you act fast, Motion VFX has an exclusive limited time offer. Click the link in the video description or scan this code to check it out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.